is the most famous issue which recognized by all world society, and this is maybe one of the good example of bad human practices related to water management and how to over exploitation of nature by humanity. And but the core of this problem is around the water, limited water resources. So if we will find proper solutions how to improve water management, how to increase efficiency of water use, water management, how to increase productivity of water and land, because about 90% of water resources use it mostly for irrigated agriculture. And in Central Asia, we have a such proverb that water is life. So today, in RLC Basin, water creates about maybe 60% of income. And it's not only agriculture sector, it's industries, it's sub-sectors, agro-processing, etc. And from this point of view, the most problems rotated around water. Today one gentleman during our round table mentioned that water is stupid. Water doesn't recognize boundaries. It's flowing. And but today around water, because again this is limited factor for social, economic, and environmental and other issues, it became more and more political. And from this point of view, this round table should help us to find the proper mechanisms and solutions and maybe recommendations how to improve cooperation around water resources. First of all, it's very important that today around this table we gathered very interesting people from one side, from our Central Asia region, diplomats, because this round table was some kind of final point of 5 days training workshop on water diplomacy. And also there were some professionals related to water and RLC problems from some regional and national institutions dealing with RLC problems, but also this round table attracted attention of some specialists from Netherlands and from international organizations. And the most interesting lesson, even for me, who already more than 30 years rotated inside of this RLC problem, that I discovered that people already much better understand necessity of cooperation. And today, ambassador of Uzbekistan in Belgium, he even pronounced very, I think, significant message that water diplomacy, diplomatic way, is much cheaper rather than any technical solutions and other things. So today all people understand that only consensus, only dialogue can help find the proper solutions. Groundwater is a very sensitive issue. Still, countries not always would like to be open and today also we discussed it during our round table that water resources, it's not only surface water. We have some kind of hidden part of water resources which are underground, and also all problems in the rivers, in open water bodies, they are visible. But what are problems inside of groundwater? They are always not visible, and sometimes people cannot understand even these problems. From this point of view, of course, even groundwater issues are sensitive for Central Asian countries, but we should raise these issues. We should speak about it louder and louder, because those invisible problems can cause very significant problems in future. And we should start today. And from this point of view, I think it's very important that this roundtable was also initiated and coordinated by this International Center for Groundwater Assessment. And this is exactly the first step forward to make this problem open, more understandable, because sometimes people don't want to discuss issues which are not understandable. So if we will make more understandable these issues, I think we can then organize this dialogue more and more efficient.